Today we are going to a very unusual place which is known as Pottery Town. So I did some search on internet and what I found that it's a very old place in Bangalore where people have been into pottery making for decades. I've also done a search on Google Map to just find where this place exactly is. So from MG Road it just takes 12 minutes. I also searched on Google Images and I could find really beautiful pictures of Pottery Town, people making pots and clay lamps, and it was really impressive, one place you can actually go and see. And then I searched on YouTube, I found a very impressive video in which it was being shown how a potter is at work, how he works on the wheel. So it's being very nicely shown. So Pottery Town is very famous with creative photographers, it's very famous with photographers. Also, I can say it's very near to Cantonment Railway Station. So I must say pottery making must be a very fascinating art. I haven't seen anybody teaching pottery making here, but I did find some of the places in Bangalore. For example, there's one place called Claytopia, which is in Indira Nagar. They teach you how to do clay painting. Then there's one place called Doodle Dun, which is in Richmond Town. So according to their website, they say that how to potter away in that in Doodle Dun, and then how to do ceramic painting. So that's all I found on the internet. Let's go and see what this place turns out to be. Okay, so today we went to Pottery Town, which the map says that it's in Fraser Town. So we had a map with us and we followed the routes which were in the map. Initially we got something called a sheep markets, where there were a lot of sheep were slaughtered for the upcoming Eid. Then we moved ahead and there were a lot of diversions and small roads. It was a little difficult task to reach Pottery Town, but we asked a lot of folks nearby. Then we reached Pottery Town and I can say that it was overall a good experience to see how the potters work.
The lane behind me is Pottery Town. Pots of every size and shape were piled in front of their homes. Right here behind me is a pottery kiln, a heated enclosure where a number of pots are first being made on wheels and fired in large mud brick kilns fueled with brushwood. I went inside one of the potter's home and a person directed me to a house where the pottery is being made. Since it had rained, I couldn't find a single potter at wheel, though I did see a potter at work on a statue. बहुत सुंदर बना रहे हो आप बंगाल से हो He did let me try my hand at the statue.
आपको कितना टाइम लगता है करने में
वो बोलने को नहीं होता
There is always a high demand of pottery, especially during festivals. The potters make traditional clay lamps, water pots, cups, flower pots, vases, candle holders and statues of gods. The experience was awesome. This is one of the homes we went inside.
Now that we have seen Pottery Town, I would like to let you know the advantage and disadvantage of this place. So this disadvantage of this place is that before reaching Pottery Town, there are a lot of diversions and very narrow roads. So it's not very easy to locate Pottery Town. Advantage of this place is that you can see live pottery making in any of the potter's home. You can actually go, click pics, and you can see how the pottery is being made. So what do you think I should rate it as? I should give it a 7.